What's up, guys? So in this video, I'm going to record for you how I warm up before I go dunk or jump. So let's get into this video. I'll walk you guys through it. All right, so I was gonna actually talk through the warm-up while I was at the gym, but I ended up getting a little bit crowded and I just wanted to make sure I had some clips for you guys to show you actually what I did, and then I'm just gonna talk through them on the screen right now. So basically with any kind of dynamic warm-up or really any warm-up I do before I dunk or play basketball, I will just work in any kind of movements that I feel like is gonna get me energized and get me moving, and might mimic some of the movements I'm gonna do on the court. So I start off with resistance band walks, because usually before I get to the gym, I would have been sitting for some extended period of time before that. So this just adds some resistance to the hips and glutes. So that kind of helps warm those up a little bit. And then once I feel like I've engaged those, that's when I'll start to work in some more dynamic stuff like skipping, which you guys see me doing here. I'll work in double tap skips, regular skips, power skips, or single leg sprints, or really, like I said, I just like to mix it up to do whatever is going to feel like it's going to get me energized and get me going to go play or jump on the court. So today I did double tap skips after the resistance band walks, and then after that is when I'll also work in some foam rolling. So that's just another thing I'll throw in sometimes, but not all the time. And that's because if I'm feeling some knee soreness, lately it's been my left knee, if I feel any knee soreness or really soreness anywhere from the prior workout that I did maybe the day before or 2 days before, I'll roll that area a little bit and just to loosen that up so I can continue to warm up and feel loose going into the dunk session or playing basketball or whatever I'm gonna do that day. So I worked in some foam rolling today, basically just on my left quad, just to loosen that up, because I notice when I have knee pain, it's usually my left quad that'll get tight, and that's what will cause some of the knee pain. So I'll loosen up that, and then my hip, I worked on my hip a little bit, and then after that is when I actually did the med ball throws. Now these are the exercises before this med ball throw will usually change, but this med ball throw that I like to do, this one will almost always stay the same, and that's just because it's a weighted movement that gets my whole body engaged, and it's similar to actually doing a full-on jump. So right here I'm holding 16 pounds, and normally I won't go above 20 pounds for these, just because at that point it's just feeling a little, it's feeling like it's a little bit too heavy, and I don't want to, you know, risk getting injured or something. So I just like to use a lighter weight that I can move faster with. So like I said, I'm using 16 pounds here, and I really try to get a full extension before I go into the movement. So I'll hold the ball over my head for a couple seconds, stay tight, stabilize, and then I'll focus on going down fast and then exploding up and extending back as far as I can. So I always do a few of those usually before I go jump or dunk, or like I said, play anything or do anything on the court. So that's basically how these dynamic warm-ups will go. Like I said, sometimes they'll change and I won't do the same exercises every time for a warm-up, but it's always something that gets me moving and that's going to kind of mimic what I'm going to be doing on the court. And when it comes to static stretching, I've had a few questions on static stretching. There have been some studies that say static stretching is not the best thing to do before jumping or some explosive movement because it can decrease your force output. But in terms of how conclusive that is, it's not really known. So if you feel like some static stretching beforehand helps you, then, you know, don't think it's like going to decrease, you know, how high you can jump or anything like that if you're just doing a little bit of it. Because sometimes I'll even do some static stretching. I might add like a bounce to the stretch just to incorporate some movement and kind of get a little bit deeper into the stretch, but I won't usually do full-on static stretching like I'll do my recovery days or even after workouts. So that's basically how I go through my warm-ups. If you guys have any other questions, leave them in the comments below. But in the next video that you guys see, that will be a full dunk session. I actually have a new gym that I'm gonna go try out. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.